Hey guys, so for this DIY, I was inspired by the oh-so-trendy kimono, especially this one in general from Toby.com, which is actually $56, which is crazy for a kimono, and for this kimono that I'm making, it only cost me $4 for everything, so I thought that was a super amazing price, and it's super easy to make, so hope you guys enjoy this video. Keep in mind, I found this DIY kimono idea from Pinterest, so this is not my idea, but I wanted to show you guys because it's so easy to make. What you would need would obviously be some fabric. Any lightweight fabric would work. Mine was a chiffon cotton polyester blend. And then you need some scissors, some measuring tape, and some trim if you would like. It's true, now we are going to take our measurements, and for this you will need a pen, a pencil, and a ruler or a long measuring tape. So these are my personal measurements, so everyone will be different, but this is what I did. Neck to elbow, width at armhole, at the bottom, and then shoulder to thigh. Now take your fabric and fold it in half once. Now we are going to fold it in half again. Now, taking all the measurements that we had on our piece of paper, we are going to measure it out onto the fabric. Now that you measured everything, now take your scissors and cut out the pattern you just traced. This is what my pattern ended up looking like, just like my picture on my piece of paper. It's true, I crave you. We are now going to sew the sides together and make sure that your fabric is inside out. To make a V-neck, all you need to do is make a little triangle. I went over 5 inches from the middle and then I cut it. You are also going to sew the top together. To make sewing easier, make sure you have some pins to pin everything together before you sew. Now, make sure you find your middle, and mine was 12 inches since I had 24 inches altogether, and then you're gonna cut only the first layer of the fabric. Now we are gonna hem the stray edges, so basically just fold over twice, and then you're gonna pin it all together and then sew it. Just like my inspired photo, I wanted to add some lace trim, so I'm going to fold over twice and put my lace in the middle and pin it all together and then sew it. But you don't have to do this if you don't want to. And this is what it looked like after I sewed it. And we're done! This is what my finished kimono looked like, and don't worry if you don't get this on the first try. This actually took me like 5 times to actually get all the sewing right, since I'm not the best sewer, but it came out perfect. I'm so happy and proud of myself to say that, oh, I made this if someone ever asked me. And again, this was only $4 in total compared to $60 or more from any store. Here are some things to keep in mind. I suggest pausing the video right now to read this and then move on. If you decide to do this DIY, definitely show me on my Instagram or Twitter at AD17XX or leave a video response. I hope you guys like this DIY, and if you guys want more DIYs like this, definitely tell me down below. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Follow me on all my links down below, and I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Bye guys!